Hi, my name is Jason. My pronouns are he, him, and I'm a developer advocate here at Slack. When your apps need somewhere to store data, whether it's for caching purposes or long-term data storage, the best place to do this is in a data store. The data stored here will be on Slack's infrastructure, so you don't need to worry about where to host your information. This video will show you how to create a data store, do basic data store operations, how to request the required scopes to use the data store, as well as introduce the Slack CLI data store command. Let's say that your app is a bot that sends messages to users interacting with it. Depending on the type of interaction, you want to send different messages for each case. Let's create a data store definition for this. Within your Slack app project folder, create a new folder called datastores. Within this folder, we'll add a new file named messages.ts. Our data store definition will live within this file. First, we'll start by importing define data store and schema from the Dino Slack SDK. Once you've chosen a name for your data store, in our case, we've used messages, choose an attribute that will be your primary key. The primary key will act as a unique identifier for each entry within your data store. In our case, we've chosen the ID as our primary key. Next, we'll define the message attribute, which will hold our message data. We'll also add the message type, which will identify what kind of message we're storing. For example, a greeting or a question. These attributes are all regular strings that can be found within the schema types object. Lastly, we'll export our message data store so that we can import it within our manifest.ts file. With this, our data store has been fully defined. In order to instantiate our data store, we'll need to add the data store's property to our manifest file. We'll also need to add the scopes to our app that allow us to use data stores: datastore read and datastore write. Once you've done this, instantiate your datastore locally by running slack run, or in production by using slack deploy. Since we're adding new scopes to your app, if you're not an admin on your workspace, you'll need to request another approval from an admin or owner on your workspace. Let's add our first entry to our datastore. Using the datastore.poke function, we'll provide the name of the data store, as well as the item that we'd like to insert. Here, we're inserting into our messages data store an entry with an ID of 1, a message of hello there friend, and a message type of greeting. Now is a good time to introduce the Slack data stores command, found as a part of the Slack CLI. If you haven't already learned about the Slack CLI, take a look at this video here for more information. If we type Slack data stores into a terminal window, you find that you can actually interact with the data store on the command line, in addition to within code. Let's try this by inserting another item into our data store via the command line. Using this command, we'll insert another item into our data store with an ID of 2, a message of I hope all is well, and a message type of greeting. Perfect! Now that we've added this item, we can retrieve the item in code when we need to respond to a user via the following snippet. Again, you can also do this on the command line via the following command. Let's say that we want to do an audit of all of our greetings within our messages data store. To do this, we'll need to query for more than just one item. In this case, we can use the datastore.query command. Let's look for all of the entries with the type of greeting. The datastore.query function relies on the DynamoDB query syntax. For more information on the specifics of this, visit our documentation site, which is in the description box below. When using a query, we'll first define the datastore name. Next, we'll define our expression using placeholders, demarcated by the hash and colon characters. In this case, we're looking for our message type attribute to start with type, where the message type is the data store attribute message type, and the type value is greeting. Once this executes, you'll find the items within the response. You could also do the same on the command line, and here's the command for that. After doing our audit, we noticed that the greeting of "I hope all is too well" was a bit too formal, and our team decided to remove it. So in order to delete an entry, we'll use the datastore.delete function and provide the ID, similar to the datastore.get function. We can check that this entry has indeed been deleted by returning to the Slack CLI and running the Slack datastore.get function. In this video, we went over how to create a datastore as well as how to interact with it. We also used the Slack datastore command as another way to interact with your datastore. Be sure to like and subscribe to our channel for more Slack content. If you have any questions, leave a comment below or join our community forums. And to continue learning, be sure to check out these other videos. See you in the next one!